Welcome along then to the North Sea coast and to the Zandvoort circuit. We're 25 miles away from Amsterdam for today's Dutch Grand Prix. It's a race the great Jim Clark won on four occasions, leading for an astonishing total of 370 laps. Four lefts and 10 rights make up the 14 corners of the narrow and demanding Zandvoort circuit, with plenty of peaks and valleys over the course of the 2.6 mile lap, which will demand absolute concentration from our drivers here today. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. It's Sergio Perez on pole today. And starting next to them is George Russell. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Sainz, Hamilton, Lando Norris, and Leclerc. Verstappen, Bottas, Ricciardo, and Clark. Fernando Alonso, Ocon, Pierre Gasly, and Hülkenberg. Stroll, Albon, Sebastian Vettel, and Mick Schumacher. Latifi, Magnussen, Joe. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. And Yuki Tsunoda. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today? Natalie Pinkham joins me once again in the commentary box. It's fantastic to have you with us today. I'm curious though, how do you think the drivers stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
The formation lap gets underway and every driver will be looking to settle in for the race ahead, making sure that their car is ready for the battle once the lights go out. We're almost ready to start the race as the cars take their positions on the grid, with the drivers and teams making their final preparations.
Make use of the overtake button and see what you can do. DRS has been enabled this lap. You can use DRS when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. New strategy available on the MFD. Copy. Approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 4.2 seconds. Nice move, keep going. Okay, gap ahead is 1.5 seconds. Green flag. Information on Stroll. Okay, they're out of this race. battery charge is high, let's use that overtake button a bit more. In this lap, push now. Yellow flag. Okay, be aware, there's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags. Verstappen stopping now. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Nico's coming in for his stop now. Gap to your teammate ahead is 11.6 seconds. To your teammate behind is 7.5 seconds. Norris has just put in the fastest lap of the race so far. And gap to the car in front is 4.1 seconds. Claire is stopping now. Second a lap on the car behind. Really good stuff. Nice overtake. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 17.2 seconds.
A great race then, and a magnificent victory here at the Dutch Grand Prix. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
I feel consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalize on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently, and it's clear to see that they've put in the work, and they should be so proud of the victory they secured here. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. Carlos Sainz extends his lead at the top, getting ever closer to securing the championship. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Natalie Pinkham, come on, who do you pick?
I have to give it to Clark. They pushed and pushed and found some fantastic performance. It was an absolute pleasure to watch.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Ferrari continue to extend the gap at the top of the table. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out. Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.